Ghosty General, it's me, the legendary knight Avory. I've come to show you who the best Leomord player is.
You're just in time, Avory. I was just about to call you for an interview. Are you ready?
A knight is always ready for battle.
Welcome back, Ghosty Gang. Today we have the top global Leomord player on YouTube with us. Let's welcome Avory. Hey, Avory, how are you doing?
Hey, I'm doing great, Jen. How about you?
Yeah, good. I'm good. How's the weather there?
It's pretty good. It's pretty good.
It's pretty good. Seems like it's a morning in there.
Yeah, it's morning.
My first question. I've noticed that you've never shown your face on your channel before. Can you tell us why you've never done a face reveal?
Well, I'm a really, really shy guy. And I'm not that talkative. Because I know we're supposed to talk during live stream. So, yeah, I never really... Okay. Showed my face.
But you show here. Okay. What did you decide to do a face reveal now during the interview?
Yeah, well, I promised my subscribers to face reveal after reaching 100,000 subs. So here am I.
So you promised to your viewers that you're going to do the face reveal on Ghost General TV when you reach the 100K subscribers?
Yes. Yes.
Thank you. I'm honored to show your first face. To be honest, you look really young. How old are you, if you don't mind?
Actually, I just turned 19 a few days ago on May 17th.
Oh, happy birthday.
Thank you.
All right, so it was a 19. So just like our previous interview, it's a China. He was also 18 years old. Mm. And then many young people are getting really good at Mobile Legends right now. Don't you agree?
Yeah, definitely. A lot of young ones are rising.
I see. Yeah. But not for me anyway. So what do you think of people your age are getting really good at the game?
I think it's because they have a lot of free time.
No. A lot of free time.
Less responsibilities. Yeah.
Not studying. No studying.
I mean, depends, you know? Depends on the people. I mean, the younger ones, they tend to play instead of study.
You're 19 right now. Yeah. So does that mean you started playing Mobile Legends while you were still in high school?
Yep, grade 7 I started playing. That was season 2, I believe.
So how did you start to play Mobile Legends? Can you tell us your story?
I always wanted to play this game, League of Legends, but I never had a PC. And so all my friends are playing, and I didn't get to play anything. Then a friend introduced me to this game called Mobile Legends. So he was like, it's like League of Legends within mobile. I'm like, okay, I'll play it. And then, yeah, I played it.
Okay, that's really interesting. And your whole life, you've lived in the UAE, the United States of Arab.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
Are you living there right now?
Yeah, I am actually. I'm in my dorm right now, university dorm.
Is Mobile Legend popular there?
Yeah, it's really popular. You can see people playing everywhere.
Oh, like in, you know, the station, bus station and subway.
Yeah, metro, yeah.
Oh, crazy. So since you live in the UAE, does that mean you play in the Middle Eastern server?
Yes, that's right. I'm in the Middle East server.
Oh, so can you tell us about the meta in the Middle Eastern server and what makes it different?
Honestly, I don't think there's much of a difference between the other servers. I mean, it mostly follows the PH meta server because there's a lot of Filipinos here. So I think they just copy whatever happens there and it brings it to this server.
I see. So last time I interviewed with the Takuyaki, the cat was in the Philippine server, and then I heard a meta, the Kimi first pick and banned Kimi.
That's barely happens here. No. We consider Kimi kind of weak here.
Okay. Oh, so how is Leomord in the Middle East server? How good is it in this meta?
I think he's pretty good in the Middle Eastern server, but with the meta, he falls off because... the heroes are really strong right now in the meta compared to Leomord. But then again, the Middle Eastern server is fairly easy. So, yeah.
Okay, so compared to the other Philippine server, Middle Eastern server is easy. That he said, guys. He said, you guys are easy. I can hear you getting the anti haters. All right. So, so I have a question that. What things Moonton develop? What things Moonton should buff for Leomord to be the meta?
I think his His second skill, it should second be skill. Lowered down. And the third skill, they should bring it back. Like, I don't care about the 50% critical for his passive. Bring back the 35%. But please bring back the cooldown reduction of the ultimate.
So since you're on the global Leomord, right?
Yep.
Oh, can I ask for your matches counter and win rate for Leomord?
So I have around 5,800 matches with Leomord and a win rate of 75%.
So almost 6,000 matches on 75% win rate.
Yeah.
Wow, that's impressive. Wow, impressive. So what did you decide to focus on Leomord? What is special about him compared to other fighters? We've already had Cho and Paquito main here on the channel. What sets Leomord apart?
Well, first of all, I focused on him because I just simply like horses and characters with swords.
Oh, so
that's one. And I think what is special about him is his combos. His combos are really satisfying. And there's a lot of variance to his combos. You can do a lot with that. You can surprise the enemy. They come, you do a combo, they're dead in that particular second. Yeah, that's what sets Leomord apart for me.
So speaking of your YouTube channel, I want to talk about some of your most popular recent videos. In this video, you got an epic 34 kills with Leomord. Do you have any tips for getting this many kills?
First one would be the proper emblem and build, so assassin and killing spree. And then second would be the proper skill combos. You gotta have to work on your combos. Next one would be timing. You gotta know when to use your skills. And of course, the next one would be prediction. You gotta predict when your enemy is gonna move here or flicker or whatever. The last one would be confidence. You gotta, for me, myself, Leomord is made to be played aggressively. You gotta use that to your advantage.
Okay, so you mentioned about the emblem and build, especially viewers really curious about the build and emblem. Are you gonna share later, like later when you try to show the introduce to your gameplay?
Yes, of course.
Sounds good. So who are some of the best counter for Leomord?
Right now it would be Mincithar, Kufra, Franco, Gaja, and Glue.
So scary, like locking CC and then no tend to dash or something. Yeah, Kufra means that definitely. Okay. Also, there's another video. In this video, you were showcasing your best build for Leomord. Do you always recommend the damage build for Leomord?
Yes, absolutely. Leomord needs to have as much damage as he can. You have to give as much gap between you, your team, and your enemy team. Because since Leomord falls in the late game, you gotta end that fast. You're gonna need a lot of damage.
Before we move on the next segment, I wanna ask you one last question. What is your favorite Leomord skin?
Right now, it would be the Abyss skin.
Why?
It's purple. I love purple.
Oh, I love purple too.
That's it. Yeah.
Oh, I see. Yeah. Okay, sounds good. So how about the new revamped skin? What do you think about it?
I mean, it's pretty great, but it kind of lacks effects for me. I love the background music while the ulti, but it still lacks effects for me.
Okay. Sounds good. So right now, we're going to move to the gameplay. I'm really excited to watch your gameplay. Alright, we're going to watch the gameplay. The enemy picked a Fanny, Mosca, Franco, Severe, Jawhead. There we go. And then Avory team has an Edith, Chang'e, Ying, Angela here. There's a really good combo. Do everyone know about the Leomord Angela combo?
Yes.
It's insane. Is there any other good hero with a Leomord?
Atlas and Kufra.
Atlas and Kufra. So you said Kufra is your counter, but Kufra will be your good teammate too.
Yeah, okay. Definitely.
I see. There's one of the you mentioned the counter Franco there. Is that fine?
Yeah, it's fine.
Okay, then seems like you're playing the jungle Leomord.
Yep.
So could you explain about the emblem right now?
Alright, well, the emblem should be killing speed, and then 3-3 movement speed, and 3-3 physical penetration.
Okay, so 3 penetration, 3 movement speed, and killing spree. Some of Leomord players use the jungle emblem. Oh, it level 2, very... Oh, it's fine. Yes, so what do you think about the jungle emblem on Leomord?
I think it won't be that good for Leomord, because since killing spree gives HP and movement speed once you kill an enemy, it's really useful for Leomord.
Okay.
It gives him more sustain.
Okay. But your team is going to be dead. Oh, level 4 already. Nice. and then keep going.
I try to get a pick. Yeah.
Look at damage, crazy. So, what is your first item?
My first item would be Hunter Strike.
What about your shoes?
It depends on the enemy, but I think what I'm using here would be the warrior boots.
Could you explain how you could choose it, which shoes you're gonna play? You're gonna use it?
Of course. Yeah, if there's my boots will basically depend on the jungle of the enemy team. So if, for example, their jungle would be a stunner jungler,
mm-hmm.
a jungler that has CC, I would use the I think it's called tough boots.
Yeah, tough
for
boots.
The less mm-hmm. less yeah, the less
CC one.
Yeah, less CC. And if the enemies are squishy, I would use swift boots for more attack speed. Because I'll be really confident if if the enemy is squishy. And the last one would be warrior boots if the enemy has good physical attack damage.
I see that while Leomord is strong. The game is definitely showing that Leomord is pretty strong with the Angela.
Yeah. Definitely.
Oh, Ferko missed the hook. Nice. The Fanny here. It seems like... Oh! Almost dead. What? What happened? What happened? Could you explain it? What happened? What just happened here?
I kind of got lucky, but I timed my skill right. Fanny missed her first skill, so I had the chance to... attack them with my first skill and second skill at the same time.
And then this is the reason that why you choose the killing spree here.
Yeah.
So you already got the 6 kills. Crazy. Is there any tip for jungling?
Oh. Let's see.
I think this savior is just a sauce. Suspicious. Isn't that the paid actor here? The paid actor? Okay. So I'm sorry about this. So, could you explain any tip for the jungling?
For jungling, they just keep jungling until you get level 4. Once you get level 4, immediately go to, let's say, maybe gold lane, and then try to kill that marksman. And then widen the gap, keep farming. And that's basically it. And make sure to always go for the squishy hero first, so you can go after the hard heroes next.
Like Savior.
Yeah, Savior, definitely.
Okay. So when you play jungle, the important thing is the total objective and Lord. What is the job for the jungler? Can you describe a detailly for how to play team fight in total fight?
And honestly, Jen, for me, in the turtle and Lord, I don't really care about the turtle.
What?
Yeah, I mostly focus on just killing the enemies and I let them take the turtle, and then later on once I get my items, I just go and I kill them. And for me, I don't really like going for the turtle,
because
if I go for the turtle, there's a chance I might die, and then that will widen the gap between me and the enemy team. So I just let them have it.
But right now you just went to 2x turtle and got it.
Yeah, because. The enemy is really weak for me, and I have the advantage. So I take that. When I have the advantage, I take the turtle.
So you just build a malefic lore. What's the reason you're building the malefic lore?
I think it should probably be for Jawhead stankiness and Franco, and also for maybe Muskov. If he gets any defense items, I can kill him easily.
Wow! I mean. So that's very interesting that you're not actually focusing on the turtle because of your for your first item. But as a result, that there's a really lot of kills, 14 kills in 6 minutes.
Yeah.
And then I feel like you don't actually care about the giant. He's throwing you every time, but you just ignore it. First skill, second skill, and kill.
Yeah. I'm really fed at this point, so I just, when I see an enemy, I just go for it.
Okay, so usually you said that you're not focused on the objective. Then what are you doing at the time?
I just kill whoever I see and let my teammates push or keep farming, get gold and get items. That's basically my objectives for me.
Okay. And then your third item? What is your third item?
My third item would be Blade of Despair. Very useful for his passive currently.
Okay, you already got the Bloodlust Axe. I mean, first item, Bloodlust Axe. I'm sorry about that.
Yeah.
Shut down.
Yeah.
So what is your first item generally?
Okay, it would be Hunter Strike.
Okay, what is the second item?
Yeah, Bloodlust Axe.
And then third item? Beauty.
Then yes.
Paid actor here. Oh, anyway, so not Malefic lore. My bad. Yeah, my bad. I think I made you confusing.
And then Blade of Despair, I go next.
Okay, sounds good. Oh, whoa, Mania. It's like an easy Mania. Oh, Savage? Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Damn, the damage is crazy. One shot, one. Even tanky. Oh, Savage.
Yeah.
Wow, level 13 and then super tanky. You just build a damage item. Muntun should nerf the Leomord more.
Yeah. No.
Yeah? Yeah?
No, God, please, no.
No.
Okay. Oh, interesting. Is there any combo tip? The ultimate combo?
Yeah, this is gonna be on ultimate. And then second skill. Then try to get the first skill at the same time. The more momentum you got for the first skill, the higher the damage. So, yeah.
Okay, so when you use the ultimate, dash into the holes and then use the first skill. When the holes is come to you, try to riding, the first skill damage combined with the ultimate. That's what you're talking about?
Yes.
So do you have to use always the second skill to use the damage, the bursting damage?
Depending on the situation, you can use it and it will give extra damage.
Okay, so second skill versus ultimate, second skill versus skill. All right, this game already over.
Yeah, I can.
23 kills and another game, one shot and 40% HP gone. Fanny level 10. How does it happen?
Oh, they really fed me and they're really squishy for me.
Oh. I feel like you don't care about to go in and die.
Yeah.
I feel like you actually have a confidence. Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. And then isn't that the Lord of Time? No.
Yeah.
You're just going. Okay. Because they're finished dead. Okay.
Yeah.
Oh, what a great ultimate. Okay, first skill. They won't see the second skill, ultimate, and first skill. Right, these guys never die. Or he's just going into their enemy base. I don't actually understand the game. Like, whenever I watch the game, he's dying every second, like a and everyone die. And yeah, everyone die. Look at this.
Everyone's dead. I got too greedy here. I died here.
Almost. I actually noticed that Fanny level 2 invade is a very former strategy and then very strong. But is there any team against the Fanny in level 2? You did it really well.
I think it's because my team also went there. You're gonna need a stunner. It was like a stun hero, a CC hero.
CC hero
with you.
Stun hero.
Yeah, CC hero with you. Yeah. And if you really can, just give it to Fanny, give your buff to Fanny, or don't try to fight her in the early game.
Okay. There's another kill, guys. I can expect it. This is not interesting. I can expect another kill here. Look at this, one shot and dead. I'm chasing. And where's it? Angela? Yeah, Angela ult, you see? I can predict everything. Now, what is the position about the Leomord in the team fight?
Oh, you always have to stay in a bush. Wait for the enemy to use their CC and then go ulti.
Okay. Ulti to the backline.
Yeah.
What is your highest kills?
Like from all seasons, it would be 53, I think.
53 kills?
53 kills. Yeah.
53 kills in rank?
Yeah.
Crazy. I'm a very objective player. I'm a very different style than you. Break ult, but survive. But he has a steel immortality. Ah. There we go. I think the Fanny is decent. Oi! Minion OP! Yo, like, I was expecting something, what's that? Something like a headache game, but this game is just, Before we say goodbye, why don't you give a quick shout out to your YouTube channel or other accounts? Let them know when you stream and post the videos too.
Shout out to myself. So please check out my YouTube channel. It's called Avory. I stream once every 2 days, depending on how busy I am. Thank you so much for having me, Jen. Please make sure to subscribe to him as well.
Me?
Give a like. And yeah.
Before we ending the video, could you give us a last tip how to play Leomord well or the how to play jungle well?
I noticed there are a lot of players using EXP Leomord. I don't recommend that. I recommend that you guys go for the jungle. Watch my gameplays and I think you can learn how. And also, don't be afraid to use your skill. So if you see a squishy enemy, just go for it. Be confident in your combos and you can one-shot that enemy. And also, there will be a lot of other combos that I can show you guys, like for example, the double dash or triangle combo, hit and run combo. I'll make a tutorial for it. So please stay tuned.
Very interesting, that double dash and triangle combo. Wow, really interesting. All right, make sure to catch his stream, guys. Thank you for dropping by, Avory. Thank you for watching your live TV. If you guys want to watch this type of video with another streamer, another YouTuber, please the like and subscribe. What's good time? All right. You're just in time. It's you're just in time, Avory. Okay, well, almost time. I'm sorry about that.